Welcome back to Life and Style. It's Tuesday. That means Artistic Tuesday. And we had Golden Tunes Kenya on Performing Arts. A really, really talented group right there. So keep supporting them. Encourage them through a word of, inspirational word, motivational word on the social media platforms. Remember to keep the conversations going on KTN Life and Style, on Facebook, KTN Life underscore Style, on Twitter and Instagram. We're on Paintbrush. And today I'm talking to a gentleman who's come all the way from Gatundu through Ruiru all the way to KTN. Karibu Joseph.
Thank you so much.
We are always happy to have people from, outside Nairobi. That means our reach is huge.
Sure.
So you watch this show a lot?
I do.
You love it?
Yeah, always. And I love it so much.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah. This is really amazing what you do. Maybe you can give us a bit of background about that and how you got into art.
Okay.
And painting especially.
Okay, thank you so much. Maybe I can start with introducing myself.
Please.
Okay, my name is Joseph Njoroge Maina, a.k.a. Jose.
Mm-hmm.
And I come from Murang'a County. Yeah?
Okay.
A sub-county called Kigumo. The village is called Marumi. But I work in Gatundu. I'm a high school teacher. I teach at a school called Ituru High School.
Mm-hmm.
It's in Gatundu South. And besides teaching, I'm a fine artist.
What do you teach?
A painter.
What do you teach?
I teach history and CRE.
Are you serious?
I'm very serious.
Okay, very, very interesting. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, besides teaching, I'm also an artist, a fine artist.
Mm-hmm.
I usually do portrait paintings, eh?
Mm-hmm.
And I also do some landscape paintings and some abstract, and I love it so much.
How long have you been doing it, and how did you get into it? Because, teaching, and then you have time for this as well. Students are not bombarding you and taking up your time.
Not really. Okay, I started arts right when I was very young.
Mm-hmm.
Even before I joined school, I loved drawing so much. I think I inherited this from my dad.
He really
used to love
artist.
Drawing, but not that elaborate, mm-hmm. just sketchy things. Eh? So mm-hmm. I happened to come across some of the drawings that he was doing, and then I developed some interest. And all this time I didn't know that this was a talent or what. When I went to primary school, the kids was very much excited around me because I loved to draw so much. My teachers would give me diagrams to draw on the blackboard. Uh-huh. Kids would be around me all the time. They want me to draw for them if some assignments are left by the teacher.
Yes.
I proceeded to high school and I was still feeling the same passion of drawing.
Mm-hmm.
I could draw teachers on blackboard.
You were those kids?
Yeah.
Were you caught at some point?
At some point, yeah.
Punished?
I remember I was punished at the time. And one of my drawing books was confiscated by my English teacher. And he thought that I was wasting time. Eh? But
Look at you now. Uh-huh.
Yeah, but despite all this, I continued with the passion. I remember I could steal some newspapers. Actually, there's one artist who has really inspired me since I was very young.
Who's that?
And that is Gado.
We've all grown up seeing Gado in our newspapers.
Gado, I remember I was borrowing newspapers every single day. And one thing that my teachers were not realizing is that when I was returning the paper, there
Gado
was page
missing.
10. It was on page 10. Gado, Katunu was missing. But they didn't know. They thought that I was trying to improve my English by reading, but I wasn't interested in everything else but the cartoon,
mm-hmm.
plus good photos that were drawable.
Okay. Yeah?
So I proceeded, but unfortunately I didn't have anyone to tell me that, Njoroge, you have a talent that mm-hmm. can take you far. But no matter how people try to discourage me, it could just come naturally. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I proceeded to university. I schooled in the University of Nairobi, where I did my Bachelor of Education in Arts. And in the first year and second year, I wasn't active in art. But in my third year, I remember I drew a drawing of a certain lecturer. He was a professor called Professor Oniango. I drew it on my cubicle, on the wall.
Are you serious?
Yeah, very serious. And every person who visited me, the first thing that they could see was the drawing.
Of a professor?
Of a professor.
Did he ever learn about it?
He didn't, unfortunately. But it was a drawing that really made a lot of people encourage me.
Ah, good.
And I can say that was my turning point. That's where when I realized that people can love art. Mm-hmm. In high school and primary school, people could not appreciate so much. But this time I realized art is likable.
True.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So I started thinking that I can commercialize my work after people suggested so to me. And actually, I started drawing my fellow students.
And they would buy the portraits?
They would buy, but I started at a rate of 5 shillings.
5 shillings?
5 shillings.
Yani umechora tu mtu kabisa.
Kabisa.
Anakupatia 5 shillings.
Yeah. I had never sold an art there
okay.
before.
Okay, yeah.
So 5 shillings, and as you know, campus life. Uh-huh. 5 shillings is enough to buy some ugali.
Yeah.
So doing 2 drawings.
You have ugali for 2 days. When you ugali na skuma?
Ugali na skuma.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's really good and very, very encouraging and inspiring that it took you to just do something and people encourage you to do it.
Sure.
So what kind of art, when you decide to do it professionally, what kind of art are you doing? Because I can see a mixture of everything.
Mostly I was so much attracted to portrait art. Mm-hmm. And actually, those are the ones that I started with. Mm-hmm. But later, especially when initially I was doing pencil work. But the reason why I decided to start painting was one project that I was promised to draw some backdrops, to paint some backdrops for drama in campus. This friend of mine called Patrick Ochiba, who told me that he used to participate in drama. Mm-hmm. He told me that their lecturer is looking for someone to paint. And because he knew that I was drawing.
So he thought he could paint.
He thought I could paint. You know, when he came to me, he asked me, Joroka, can you paint? I told him, yes, I can. But I've never even touched
that
a
is
brush.
Faith. That is faith right
yeah.
there.
So actually the following day, I went to the computer lab. There was internet. From 9 a.m, I didn't even go for lunch. Up to 3 p.m. in the evening, I was on YouTube.
Learning.
I was Googling. Searching people painting. I watched and watched and watched, and I'm telling you, the following day, I decided to sacrifice myself and the money, the little money that I had saved. I went and bought some watercolors from a nearby bookshop.
Those ones that you put water over here, then
yes.
like a small brush.
Those ones.
Okay.
Then I started recalling what I have been watching, and then I tried to just come up with an item to paint. Mm-hmm. And I remember I tried a landscape painting, a
How
river.
Was it?
Actually, I couldn't believe it myself also, and including my roommate.
They couldn't believe that you could actually do something
yeah.
that good. And so you did this background later, and was the teacher happy with it?
Actually, I did not even succeed getting the job because you were approaching the exam period.
Okay. But then this also
and,
awakened you.
It awakened me so much.
It awakened you in a way. And you talked about 5 shillings in the beginning. Mm-hmm. How much would a portrait go for now? The range?
The range. I can only give the range because the price of a portrait depends on various factors.
Like
the size, the details.
Okay.
Perhaps if you want me to draw you with your kid or with your car or your... with something else that adds more details, so
the
portrait
the
will be more expensive. Yeah? So it can range between, let's say, 3,500 and above. I can't
and
even.
Above, true.
I can't
okay.
go to the extreme end.
Okay. So how's the business been? You know, because you got into it, you're here, and I see you've got amazing frames as well. Do they come? I'm sure you charge extra for that.
Like I do, yeah.
Definitely
sure.
you do. So how has the business been, though? Like, are we appreciating art as Kenyans?
I can say that in Kenya, and I think generally in Africa, art is not much appreciated.
Okay.
Okay? And it's so unfortunate that Kenyans have got a mentality that art can only be bought by tourists. Oh. It is so wrong.
But it's so wrong.
It's so wrong.
Yes.
Actually, you'll find someone suggesting that you paint them at a rate of 500 shillings or 200 shillings.
I was about to go at the key.
I'm telling you.
What?
And some even ask me, why are you charging me 3,000 or 4,000 shillings? Well, I can go to a studio and get a photograph.
I get what you're saying. Appreciating what it is that
yes.
you're doing, the time you put in, mm-hmm. and even to the details. And I'm looking at this thing, they look so good.
Mm-hmm, thank you.
They look so, so good. This is Mr. Kabogo.
Okay, not Kabogo, it was a couple that had wanted to have their portrait done for okay. Valentine's.
There's a very beautiful similarity there. Mm-hmm. And this is Mark Masai.
Mark Masai from NTA.
Yeah, I see that as well. Really good. And this particular one of the old guy over here is the very same one that we have here.
Exactly.
So you did it once and then you thought you need to do a bigger one.
That portrait is my favorite. It's my favorite. It's the best I ever did.
How so?
And actually, I've never sold it and I'm not intending to sell it.
It's personal though.
Yeah. I did it when I was very new in painting. Uh-huh. I remember I had gone through some frustrations. After realizing that art can sell, I think I became so much money-minded. Mm-hmm. Okay? And I started thinking that if I can do a lot of art and go and sell out in supermarkets, I can be a millionaire in a week or two. Uh-huh. So I remember I went out. That time I was in Nyeri. I was in Nyeri. After campus, I went to teach at a school called South Tetu Girls in Mukoroine.
Okay.
And that's why I became so money-minded and thought about how I can draw and sell in supermarkets. And there was this supermarket that gave me some orders. And we agreed that I do like 40 pieces of art. I was sleeping for 2 hours every night for like 2 weeks. And then I did like 20 pieces and I felt, I think I should just take these 20 first and then I tell them to wait for the other 20. And actually when I went to take the first 20, they told me, Joseph, we are sorry.
Oh,
we said that we are not going to do business with you. We have a lot of art in our supermarkets and no customers, so we are sorry. Actually,
oh my God, what did you do?
They did not even tell me on my face. They called, I called them when I got there. They told me, I faced a frustration.
What did you do with the 20 paintings?
I'm telling you, some of them are still in my house. Some of them I give them out to my friends. Some of them I do not even want to look at them because they remind me of the frustration. Eh?
Yes.
So what I decided is that I am going to stop throwing for good. And I had a break of about 6 months. Mm-hmm. But after the sixth month, I found myself throwing again without knowing.
Very interesting.
But this time around, I said, I am not going to draw for money.
Okay.
I'm going to draw to please myself.
Because I want to do it, because I love it.
Because I love it.
Absolutely.
And I decided that I won't draw because I want to sell a painting. I'll draw because I want to hang it and see it and love it.
That's what happened to this guy.
So this old man, I decided I want to draw an old African man. And I used about 6 hours to draw this.
6 hours for this?
Yeah.
What?
And actually, when I posted it on social media, mm-hmm. people could not believe it. Eh?
Oh, yeah.
And what I loved more is the likes I got and the comments I got about it.
So social media has played a big role in you selling your pieces of art.
So much.
And now that you're talking about social media and my time is running out, maybe you can tell us where we can get Jose Art, where are they? Do you stock them in shops? Social mm-hmm. media, wapi, unaitwaje?
Okay, mainly because I have the full-time job of teaching. Yeah?
Yes.
I haven't ventured so much in setting up galleries or some shops. Mm-hmm. So my main platforms are social media, OLX, and that's why I get customers. If you'd like to view some of my samples of my work On Facebook, I call myself full names, Joseph Jiroga Maina, and then in brackets, Jose Art.
Ah.
I also have a page called Jose Art, mm-hmm. but mostly I realized that people do not know who is this Jose, so I decided to be posting my work on my account.
Yes.
And so you can also get to my page, Jose Art, and like it, and okay. also view some of my work.
Instagram?
Instagram, yeah, Jose Art.
Okay.
J-O-S-E-Y, at one word. Eh?
Okay.
You'll view some of my work.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. And today, mm-hmm. you have moved someone's, you've just made someone just think mm-hmm. about their life. And when they give up, mm-hmm. sometimes these things are in us. And it doesn't matter
yeah.
however much we run away from them.
Sure.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Words of encouragement. I think Artistic Tuesday just met to motivate today. And if you're sitting on that talent and thinking, you know, all I need to do is make money out of it, and you stop doing it, sometimes just do some things to, you know, encourage yourself. Because here you are, Jose.
Yes.
You didn't do it for money, but you made money.
Sure.
You're making money out of it.
Yeah.
All right, this has been Paint Brush. We are taking a very short commercial break. When we come back, it's all about visual arts.